Welcome to Migrating Running Business Critical SAP Workloads. My name is Ralf Roth, and here we go. So I give you an overview about the migration project itself, about the customer itself, DM is his name, short overview about SUSE Consulting, then the business driver and the challenges we face in that migration project, and how SUSE Consulting helped here the customer in his journey. I will give details on the migration itself. It's two phases, phase one and two. Details about the migration, technical stuff, and at the end, lesson learned and key takeaways. So what's it about? It's about migrating running business critical SAP workloads. The customer comes from IIX and IBM hosts and migrates from there in the first step to /4SAP application 11. And then in the second project, we upgrade that 11 environment to 12. And the emphasis is here. It's almost done during normal working hours or on very short downtime. It's not a technical deep dive into SAP or SUSE Linux Enterprise Server for SAP application. The main focus is on drivers, how we did it, and how we are successful in this migration project. I also will give you an outlook of ongoing changes and what is ahead for the customer. So this is the overview, the big picture about the SAP migration of the customer and also consolidation, renewal of the whole architecture. At the bottom, you see a timeline starting in the year 2014. And on the right, you see 2020. The red bar is more or less where we are now, actually. So we have, as I said, two phases, one and two. Yeah. Customer started with IBM host and IX servers. On the host, there was the SAP central instance, CI, and the database, DB. And on the IX servers, where the application servers, RS. And we migrated that to /11 with DB2 and later in a step to HANA 1.0. So that's why I have written here phase 1 and 1.5. The second step was migrating the database DB2 to HANA 1. And later we migrated that environment from /11 to 12 and doing, that's phase 2, in the phase 2.5, also an upgrade from the database from HANA 1 to 2. Yeah. And as said, I will give an outlook on ongoing projects like moving to the cloud or upgrading to /15 or new projects like introducing S4HANA. So that's the big picture, and I will go now into details about the phases and how we did it and challenges and business drivers. Okay, about the customer itself, it's DM, that's short for Drogeriemarkt. On the right edge you see here Eastern Europe and Germany, where DM does his business. You see his logo. DM is Germany's largest retailer, measured by revenues, has more than 62,000 people employees and 3,600 stores, 13 European countries, and 11 billion euros revenue per year. About DM Tech, DM Tech is the IT daughter of DM. With about 800 employees, and they are responsible for the online web shop, the website. Also, they have apps for your mobile phone they care about. Then the IT in the stores, the outlets itself, Then they have distribution centers where all the goods are distributed, and head offices, it's also their responsibility. And of course, central systems running on SAP, and that's where we are focusing here in this presentation, on those SAP systems. Then about SUSE Consulting. SUSE Consulting does product consulting and also architecture and solution consulting, health check, migration, just like here, for example, SAP migrations. Some words about me, Ralf Roth. I'm in touch with Linux since more or less the first kernels that are out in the past on all major commercial Unix platforms, 25 years in various consulting roles and positions. My focus is on solution design and architecture, mainly around SAP, high availability, and Linux itself. I'm, as you may can hear, from Germany, a bit north of Frankfurt. Okay, so the migration project itself. Some details on the first migration. So yeah, why? Why does customer want to do this? Of course, there are some business drivers, like overall cost to maintain the IBM hosts and the IX servers. Customer sees the vendor login here. Also support for his database, DB6 on host, yeah, to be more agile. Also rising workloads or dynamic workloads was all a business driver, yeah. Standardization, automation, replatforming. But I think one of the major drivers for the customer was the more or less mandatory move to SAP HANA. And also to S/4HANA. Yeah. Also a business driver was how to manage the old environment. Yeah. Okay, so the customer sees these challenges for that migration project. He was new to Linux. His staff needs training, yeah, on Linux, training on the job. An architectural concept needs to be designed. Yeah. Then the migration, the overall migration, there's a new operating system, yeah, so you need new scripts, new tools, Active Directory integration, the SAP RPC calls needs to be checked, yeah, interfaces from SAP needs to be checked, even such yeah, simple things like file transfer needs to be yeah, checked and keep in mind. Then also the move of the database itself, it's called DB6 on host and DB2 on Linux in the first step, and later then to SAP HANA in another step. Yeah. Then also challenge was complete new hardware. Yeah. As a hypervisor, they used VMware, so that's also a yeah, new challenge. The SAN, network storage, stuff like that, all new. Yeah. And the big question, yeah, how to do it, how to do the migration. Yeah. And the business, as you know, mission critical, SAP, more or less, yeah, no downtime due to the migration. Yeah. So the challenge was here to do the migration itself and keep the downtime as small as possible. So how SUSE Consulting helped here? Yeah, we were introduced by sales and started very fast with architectural overall discussion how to design that solution. For example, to use a greenfield approach versus a brownfield, yeah, or mix means best of both approaches. Yeah. So yeah, discussing how to do the database migration, SAP multi-tier instances, the sub landscape, retail, stuff like that. So a lot of discussion about SAP and how to set them up. also about high availability in disaster recovery. If you go to a new platform, yeah, you need to have a new disaster recovery concept in place. We used here RIA that SUSE provides and supports. What is available here, yeah, I said RIA, yeah. Then the migration roadmap was defined, no? What to do, who do what, yeah, when, how. And then, yeah, the new landscape was sized, planned. We have a two data center approach and roll out. So planning the first steps, architecture and project management. Yeah. You need the architecture, design, yeah, and the desired state. So this will end up in a project plan and work breakdown structure. So it's a good thing to have project management by side that helps you here. Yeah. Then what do we need? Hardware, software, storage, network, and so on. Huh? And also the question is, yeah, our operating system layout, how does it look, how many disks, how does the SAP data layout look like? So a lot of discussion and yeah, architecture and design questions. Then the customer does an initial sizing. Yeah, if you know SAP, you measure it by subs and doing a memory design, yeah, how storage is used, and for example, the placement of productive and development instances. Yeah, then the customer ordered it, and that's the wiring of the whole environment. So, question, how to roll out the OS installation, how to maintain them? So, yeah, you need a lifecycle management in place, means from the birth of an operating system to his whole life, yeah, till the end, till you delete it. Yeah, so you need a golden image. Yeah, what comes in, it needs to be hardened, the disk layout. It's important to have t-shirt size, so we define that different t-shirt size for different size of, for example, HANAs. Yeah, it's very important to have a base patch line concept. Yeah. We are doing patches on, for example, quarterly basis, yeah. But for patching, you need management support and user acceptance. That's very important. Yeah, and then you have to set up a bare metal installation. Yeah, we used here AutoJust and also yeah, configuration management to roll out configuration files. And yeah, also you need some scripts for reoccurring management tasks and setup tasks. So at the end, we ended up with 15 to 20 scripts that help us in the rollout. Yeah, we have all that done with the help of SUSE Manager, and there's also a success story you could read about how we did it with SUSE Manager. Okay, so we have put it now everything in place. Yeah, so we have now the possibility to roll out an operating system, but yeah, that's only the start. So from a sub basis point of view, we are ready to go on. Yeah, so how to migrate the SAP. We have done identical SAP setup, so that means on the new hardware we've put more or less a one-to-one clone of the SAP instance. Yeah. As said, we had in the past a multi-tier SAP setup. Here we choose a monolithic setup, but more or less a two-tier setup, so everything in one box. Yeah. We use the same SID, the same instance number. The SID RDMs are the same. Even the users, the user ID are the same. So more or less, it was a one-to-one clone of the environment on host and IX. But the host name, the hotel host name we used here, was in a different IP range. Yeah, so we could test the whole operating system, doing backup in disaster recoveries, yeah, tested it, looking if it's working, starting, stopping, yeah, handing it over to key users that they are doing their testing and user acceptance testing, and then we got the okay, yeah. It looks everything fine. You could migrate the SAP instance from the old hardware to the new one. So downtime was coordinated with the business owners, and we are doing a final sync of the database. Syncing the database, we are using the tool from SAP, the Software Update Manager, DMO, Database Migration Option, that does a sync more or less on the fly on small deltas. Yeah, so we could do at the downtime a very short a sync, yeah, taking then the old environment offline and started the new environment. Yeah, and now we simply switched the virtual host names. Yeah. Via DNS, yeah, and yeah, more or less the whole migration took the time for the final sync and switching the hostname and propagating the virtual hostname via DNS. So yeah, this is normally between 15 and 30 minutes. Yeah, so after that 15 to 30 minutes, you could already start with testing, key user testing. Yeah. So therefore, sandboxes, test environment, dev environment, we are doing during normal working hours. Yeah. And for the productive system, we selected after hours or weekends, and there we have a longer downtime for more testing. Yeah. But as said, the real downtime was between, let's say, 15 minutes to 30 minutes, yeah, and then the environment was more or less moved to the new one. Yeah. So after that migration, life is ongoing. As said, the DB2 database was then replaced by SAP HANA 1. Yeah, that was done by a partner, so no SUSE involvement. But we helped DM on maintaining the operating system, tweaking, tuning, patching. Yeah, so the ongoing stuff. Then 2 or 3 years passed. Yeah. Everything runs fine. Okay, so challenges so far. Yeah, for the customer, it was the move from the host and IX to VMware. That was a major challenge. Also, all new SAN, NFS storage infrastructure had to be newly rebuilt for SAP. As said, new platform, you need a new backup and disaster recovery concept, the maintenance, the monitoring of the new environment. So all has to be fresh developed. Yeah. The customer also use UC4 or automation for his process automation beside SUSE Manager. So that has to be tested, rewritten. Yeah. If you build a new environment, you have to keep in mind to do hardening, to lease rights, doing security audits, using, for example, sudo, lowering the rights for the SAP admins, so that more or less has all been reinvented for that project, for that migration. Also, as said, all those FTP servers, data transfer, remote procedure calls was a challenge to get it right. Also, that you need new licenses for a solution manager. So going to the second migration, I will give you some details. So we are now already on SUSE Linux Enterprise for SAP application. Yeah, but there are some business driver with new and additional tasks. So from a point of support, it was a time to update SAS for SAP application from 11 to 2. Yeah. And also updating the database HANA 1.0 to 2.0. Also at the customer responsibilities and teams have changed, so not all the members from the first migration were in this team. Yeah. Also the customer wants to use infrastructure as a code approach with the new project, and also the networks changed, means shares, backups, how to do backups, firewalling, stuff like that. Also here wants to have a full Active Directory integration. So a lot of new business drivers, yeah, we have to keep in mind, and again, with less downtime as possible. Yeah. So on the right you see a picture, yeah, with we are coming from the left going to 12, and that's phase 2, and in this second project we are updating then HANA from 1. To 2.0. Yeah. I'll give you an outlook on cloud and /15 later. So again, to the migration, yeah, preparing stages, challenges. Again, the question, which approach, greenfield versus brownfield, that means the in-place upgrade from 11 to 12, or do we install everything new? Yeah, we decided to install everything new. Then infrastructure as a code needs really good planning. Yeah. Infrastructure as a code needs some parameters, so you have to define the roles, for example HANA, NetWeaver, or other systems. Yeah, the SIT we use, the IP we use, what patch months we are using. Yeah. Then the challenge is here the infrastructure setup, and also I said people needs to be trained. Yeah. And this project we are using the new Subtune from SUSE. Yeah, that helps us a lot in tuning the workloads, for example tuning for HANA or NetWeaver, and we included Subtune also in infrastructure as a code. Then we also faced some technical challenges because LES 12 has some major changes, like systemd versus the init system5. Yeah. Frameworks, so all scripts using sudo, su, or C groups needs to be reviewed, and also we had to write some scripts. Yeah, there are some deprecated commands like ifconfig we have to check out, and we could not reuse from 11 the AutoJAS profiles. We have to, yeah, to do it new. So that was the challenges we faced here in that migration project. Then the doing itself, yeah, the customer setup complete deployment infrastructure, CI/CD pipeline, with also connecting SUSE Manager to it. Yeah, we created again a golden image. Yeah, have it in place, tested it, and it was working for rollout. And as said, we are using here greenfield approach, setting up additional new MTVM. Yeah. With 12, and just like in the last migration, more or less a one-to-one clone, same instance number, same SIT, same users, but only different network segments, different IP, and again, the virtual host name was used here and switched later. Yeah. We decided here to do the SAP migration first, yeah, moving from 11 to 12, and later doing then the HANA upgrade from 1 to 2. Yeah. The SAP HANA migration we've done using a self-written script. So this script more or less does delta syncs from the database, from the HANA database. So the first sync, for example, for a bigger installation, used 27 hours. Yeah. And the more we are doing delta sync, at the end we ended up in 30 to 15 minutes sync. Yeah. So again, the non-business critical system we migrated during working hours. Yeah. And the switch and doing the final sync takes around 30 minutes. Yeah. So again, we could after a good and intensive testing. A switch in 30 minutes. Yeah. So I will give you an outlook of ongoing projects. Yeah. For example, a few systems we have moved to the public cloud. Maybe a few others will follow. Yeah. Then business requirement is to use SAP HANA system replication. Yeah. And we all already discussed you could also do automation of that replication using the SUSE tools. Then customer looks for live patching. Yeah, that's one of the next projects. And from a business requirement, S4HANA needs to be validated and roll out for next year. So for S4HANA, we need or we decided to use Less for SAP application version 15. Yeah, so again, the story begins again. Yeah, currently we are 12, so yeah, we have to prepare to move to 15. Yeah, so the headline is the only constant is change. Yeah, again, things are changing. Yeah, not all systems will be removed. They will stay on the 12 latest service pack and will then replace them by modern S4HANA implementations. Yeah. So lessons learned and key takeaway. We have here a technical view and a business view. What we have learned so far, a technical view, using virtual host names, aliases, was one of the success factors because we could simply change them via DNS. We had a naming schema here in place help us a lot. For the second migration, moving the HANA database, fast Ethernet was key. Yeah, you need here for this type of migration a very fast Ethernet. Yeah. Then the consistency of SAP SIDs, SAP instance numbers, the user being on the same IDs, group IDs, was a success factor. Then also that we have done automation of complex configurations, yeah, and infrastructure as a code, yeah, means repeatable and also works on weekends. And of course that we use new tools like asset subtune. Yeah. And one of the learnings was, you need a backup and disaster recovery concept. You had to test it before documented that you could reuse it. Very important, breakdown of the technical complexity into smaller manageable parts. As you may remember, we have phase 1 and 2, and also there was 1.5 and 2.5. So we decided to break down such complex migration project in smaller parts and doing it step by step so we could handle them better. Management view. You should understand the complexity of such migration projects, and of course you need additional resources in people and hardware. Yeah. Design, planning and architecture is essential. Yeah. Align it to your business driver. Very important to buy in management, system admins, end users and getting support from them. Yeah. use baseline patching. That means repeatable results. Yeah, the migration itself must be scheduled and before tested. Yeah. Important to have a lifecycle management plan and solution in place. We use here the SUSE manager. Yeah. It's important to have the people trained and able. SUSE can help here. Yeah. It's a lot of change and re-implementation and re-engineering project. So if you have not yet started, yeah, you know Sapana on Linux is coming. Yeah, hopefully you have some ideas about the overall complexity, that it takes time to do it. Yeah, that architecture design and proper planning is key here. Yeah. Buying in of all stakeholders is key. Yeah, Stack for SAP application for sure is the platform to do such migrations, and SUSE Consulting can help and assist you here on your journey towards such a migration. So thank you. Yeah,